The split between the President of the United States and his top doctors seems to have cracked wide open. President Trump this morning retweeting a former game show host and conspiracy theorist who accused the CDC and doctors of lying about the coronavirus in order to keep the economy closed and hurt Trump politically, a rather deranged accusation. Meanwhile, the White House is trying to undermine the nation's leading infectious disease expert, Dr. Anthony Fauci, disseminating what essentially amounts to opposition research against Fauci, taking quotes of his out of context, trashing him anonymously to reporters, a clear coordinated effort to undermine Dr. Fauci. So yes, just to sum up, I want to make sure you heard me correctly. The president, in the middle of a pandemic, is promoting the views of the virus of Chuck Woolery, while his White House is attacking Dr. Anthony Fauci. Moments ago, President Trump talked about this, as CNN's Caitlin Collins reports.
After multiple attempts to undercut him, the White House insisted today that President Trump isn't trying to discredit Dr. Anthony Fauci.
I find him to be a very nice person. I don't always agree with him.
Press Secretary Kayleigh McEnany denied having anonymous officials distribute opposition-style research to reporters after they did just that over the weekend.
There's no opposition research being dumped to reporters, and we provided a direct answer to what was a direct question.
Though Trump has criticized anonymous sources in the past, an anonymous administration official claimed aides were concerned about the times Fauci had been wrong and circulated a list of bullet points with statements like this from early March.
There's no reason to be walking around with a mask.
The list did not include statements from other officials who have also been wrong, like the Surgeon General, and it didn't include any of the president's false claims either.
Anybody that needs a test gets a test.
Instead, when it comes to medical advice, the president appears to now be turning to the former Love Connection game show host, Chuck Woolery.
What does it take for you to fall in love, Francie?
Trump retweeted Woolery after he claimed everyone, including the CDC, media, Democrats, and most doctors, are lying about COVID-19 in an attempt to hurt Trump politically. McEnany said the tweet was directed at rogue individuals inside the CDC who have leaked draft documents of reopening guidance.
When we use science, we have to use it in a way that is not political.
It's a similar sentiment to the one once echoed by Trump's former chief of staff.
That they think this is going to be what brings down the president. That's what this is all about.
But Mick Mulvaney appears to have reversed course. In a new op-ed today, Mulvaney cites firsthand experience that the U.S. has a testing problem, saying his own son waited 5 to 7 days for results while his daughter was denied a test altogether. Asked to respond to Mulvaney's criticism, the White House cited the number of tests conducted but ignored the long delays in getting results.
Our reaction is that we've tested, we lead the world in testing. We've done more than 40 million tests. That's an extraordinary number.
Now, Jake, when the president was speaking with reporters today, he did not acknowledge the delays in getting test results that we're seeing across the country. Instead, only talked about how testing has increased over the last several months and repeated his wrong claim that that's the reason we're seeing more cases here in the U.S. And when it comes to Fauci and Trump, we do want to note that Fauci has worked in the government since 1984. It's incredibly difficult to fire him. It would have to be for cause, and it would likely have to be someone like the HHS secretary who would actually have to fire Dr. Fauci. And we should note that the president has been warned and advised that doing so, trying to remove him from his position, could be damaging politically.
Joining me right now is David Axelrod, former senior advisor to in the Obama White House. It's good to see you, David, under really remarkable circumstances, but they all are at this point. I mean, what did you think when you saw this coming out this weekend?
I thought it was predictable and appalling. You could see that the president was on a collision course with Dr. Fauci, because Dr. Fauci keeps trying to sound the alarm about this raging inferno of a pandemic, and the president keeps wanting to ignore it, and Dr. Fauci has become inconvenient for the president. So, you know, it didn't surprise me, and it's crazy for Kayleigh McEnany to say, they've always had a good relationship. Imagine how you get treated if you have a bad relationship, if you have a good relationship and they send out oppo research on you. And the thing about the research was that it was misleading, because they excised portions of what Dr. Fauci said that were inconvenient to their argument. So, you know, It's really, and then this morning to read him, or to see him retweeting that noted public health expert, Chuck Woolery, the creator of The Love Connection, the game show host, attacking the CDC, attacking doctors. This is so, so destructive at a time when we need to pull together as a country and deal with what is a major crisis.
When you just kind of think of a statement of priorities, because this doesn't happen in a vacuum. Well, tell me what you think. As someone who's been in part of many a campaign and in a White House, does opposition research just happen by one person who decides to put it out? I mean, there is a conversation and a strategic choice when you go at someone like this.
Yeah. My guess is this came from the top. I don't think this was generated by middle management. And, you know, it was part. They were defending the president, who said the night before, or I guess it was the night before on Fox, that Dr. Fauci had made a lot of mistakes. And so they were trying to back up that ridiculous claim. And that's how this thing unfolded. But, you know, in terms of what is their priority is one, which is to try and win re-election. That was why the president was so eager to deny the fact of the virus in the first instance that cost us 6 weeks at the beginning. And that's why for the last several weeks, he's been ignoring the obvious upsurge.
But David, just
the
take the last 72 hours. Honestly, if you yeah. just working to discredit Anthony Fauci, retweeting Chuck Woolery saying that the CDC is lying, but then you also have him commuting Roger Stone's sentence, and Michael Cohen is sent back to prison because his attorneys say he wouldn't agree to stop writing a book. Do you see a through line here?
Well, if you were looking at it objectively, you'd say this isn't a guy who seems like he's working hard to get reelected. I'd say that. I mean, these aren't strategies calculated to get reelected. I've said from the beginning, if the president had handled the virus straight up, if he had done what so many governors have done and taken the advice of public health experts and given the facts to the public and talked about the sacrifices that were necessary and why, he may well have put this election away, and instead he couldn't, and he went in a different direction, and I think he's dug himself into a deep hole. On the Roger Stone piece, look, that too was appalling but not surprising. The president's been signaling that from the beginning. It was an act of abject corruption, but probably not as damaging to his chances, because that's sort of baked in the cake by now, as the way he's handling these issues that are touching people's lives on a daily basis. You know, you can't spin a pandemic. People are living the reality of it. Mm-hmm. And when you deny it, and when you say it's just going to go away, when the intensive care units are filling up, you know, you're going to run into a wall on this, and the president has.